So I was over here today, PA Street Scene came by the house. We worked on this hood for him. And this is Derek. If you don't know who Derek is, you need to check out his channel,
How's
PA
going,
Street
guys?
Scene. So his R32 was keyed by some butthole. And I just want to say to you, if you're watching this, I wasn't going to let you ruin this car. And we took a while, but we got this thing looking about as good as it's going to go. But not too bad at all.
Awesome, it's so pretty.
I know.
It's all like purple,
that,
greens, and blues.
That is wild.
Car really came out nice. But anyway, here's his Instagram. Check that out. I'm sure you guys have seen this car. It was graffitied around Central Pennsylvania for a while, and then he did a thing at Christmas where it was covered. How many lights was this thing covered in?
Close to 2,000
Christmas lights.
I think it was like 700 feet of Christmas
lights. 700 feet of Christmas lights. Awesome. So he took all that off, and he put it back to the original color, and put a little...
Shark.
Is that shark? A little shark look
like
on...
A bomber sticker
on it, but it looks good. Hey, welcome to Driven Compete channel. I'm here today, and it's kind of cool because I'm helping out a friend, PA Street Scene. If you haven't been on his channel, please check it out. PA Street Scene, all one word. And today I'm going to be buffing on his R32 because somebody keyed it. I've already gone through it, and I've fixed the hood for him, and it turned out really well. I was just happy to get all those scratches out. But, you know, the real part of the video is going to be test driving the R32 owner test drives the IE Stage 2 Golf R. So stay tuned. I hope you like the video.
I really like the steering wheel on this.
And I don't know if you're in race mode.
Yeah, how do you switch modes?
The mode's lit up down there. So,
where?
Right there.
Oh, I got it.
Mode button. You hit the mode button.
Yep.
You're in race. Okay, that's the one you want to be in. Now reach down and turn traction control.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Does it tell you if it's off?
It told me. It told you if it was off in the dash. It's telling you now. When you look in there, it says it's off.
It's so quiet.
I know. So, and then you can go sport mode yet too on the trans. So you're in race mode, but you're in.
This is where we're going. We're going that way.
How do you change the trans?
Go right. Just pull the trans back one bump and it goes into sport mode.
Which is paddle
right
shifters?
There, right there.
Yep.
You can paddle shift in any mode.
Oh, okay.
But this is.
Definitely feels like a brand new car, that's for sure.
Geez, that washed up.
Yeah.
Didn't it?
Oh, got a car coming. Thanks, Dad.
Sure, not a problem.
So, do you want me to punch it?
Sure, go ahead.
Turning radius is good.
Might have to help him. I don't know if you can see or not.
Yeah, I think we're good.
It's clear.
Wow.
Good.
Those shifts are so fast.
Yep.
What do you think?
Shifts great.
Now, if you bump it back, it goes into nice mode.
What do you mean?
Bumps the shifter back, it goes into like normal mode, so then it drops
another gear. I felt it change. Yeah.
So now you're in sixth.
See, that's the problem with the Mark IV R32. Sixth gear is useless. The only thing it's good for is if you're on a long highway drive and you want to smooth out a bit. But there's no other real benefit.
So, what do you think? You getting ready? You thinking about a Mark VII anytime soon?
If I hit the lottery, I'll grab it.
Turning radius is good.
May have to help him. I don't know if you can see or not.
Yeah, I think we're good.
Wow.
Yeah.
Those shifts are so fast.
Yep.
What do you think?
Shifts.
All right, Sean, where do you want us to switch at so I can feel this launch?
Find a place that you feel comfortable and over. And,
it is just shocking to me that it's that quick and that quiet at the same time.
Yeah, I know. Isn't it?
Like you.
I mean, it is literally the perfect sleeper.
Yeah, I think the only thing I would do if you were trying to go more sleeper with it is I would probably black out the R logos.
Pull over right here.
Or I'll pull over up here. Yeah, this one?
Yeah. It's probably fine.
Yeah. Is that good?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Switch!
Here, I'll get the back.
Put some Mark 32 logos on that. Would it be bad to put R32 on it? A lot of people are taking the R32 and putting the R logos.
Yeah.
Oh, it's in there. Probably a lot of R32 badges out there.
I can't decide if I want to debadge my hatch or not. Do it uphill too.
I'll do it uphill.
Wow.
Wow. And now we'll slow down and make the turn.
That is really surprising.
You impressed?
Like it kind of, I wasn't expecting, I knew it was going to put me back in my seat because I've ridden the Mark VI. But it knocks a little bit of the wind out of your lungs. Like it's you don't expect that. Are you gonna do it uphill too?
I'll do it uphill.
Wow. Wow.
And now we'll slow down and make the turn.
That is.
Yeah, there's a lot of people out of work, a lot of families that are. I'm very blessed to be able to still have what I have at the moment.
As am I.
You know, I'm not ready to put this up for sale yet, YouTube. Maybe, you know, if I don't go back to work here in a few months.
It's definitely a completely different experience than the Mark IV. Like, the Mark IV
is more raw, isn't it?
It feels more raw in that because it's more bare bones.
Yeah.
But this seems more dialed in. And granted, you have a tune and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like that only has stage one. And with the automatic shifting and stuff, I would like to play around with the paddles. Although, like I said when I first got into it, I'm surprised that they're not more like a true paddle.
I have them on order.
They're like a button.
Yeah, no, I have a larger one on order. And I went with silver because everything's black and silver in here.
Yeah.
So, but I have those on order.
Yeah, it's lots of fun, that's for sure.
Cool.
So
I'm glad you like it.
Someday. Although by the time I get to it, I'll probably be up to Mark 9 or Mark 10 by then.
So, you want to tell them which channel they need to watch?
Yeah. So
yours and mine?
You can catch Sean and the crew, as we're calling it the crew now, on Driven to Compete. And if you enjoy Mark IV R32 content, you can follow me at PA Street Scene, all one word. Also on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. And I guess we'll see you guys next time.
Don't forget to subscribe if you like the videos. And as I always say, thanks for watching Driven to Compete. Watch, like, subscribe. Just the